Hey, what's up, everyone? I'm Roland Fox, and
nipple
welcome.
Nipple clamps.
Hi, Will. That was Thespio, aka DeWilstonator, aka you know who.
Keyframe ain't here, so I gotta be his replacement bitch.
Wow. Oh my
okay,
God.
Okay, now that's me.
Oh Jesus Christ. So yeah, I'm Goal of Vox Dreams, Donkey Kong Country, gotta finish it. Including me is Lightning Bliss and Toon Critic by 2K. And Sad Over Song.
I was going to say, it's like, and?
You're not, nobody just Sapphire.
Yeah.
Cry every time.
Cry every Tim.
Hey, hey, Will, how many bucks do you need? Four or five?
Five!
God damn it, just say five!
Sorry.
Do you want to know why I got these braces?
Why? Okay, I'm not gonna do that throughout the whole thing.
Hey, what do you want with your burgers?
Fries! Flesh assault!
Shut the fuck up.
No! Okay,
now I just die!
La 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 la.
Whoa! Don't touch that fish! Don't touch that fish!
Can't touch that.
That's the fish that was fucking you over last time.
Oh.
Never mind, you got killed by another fish anyway.
Oh, wait! I forgot. I got a share screen. That would really fucking help. Okay, Where is it? Do-do-do-do-do, share a window, and boom. There.
Whoops.
I gotta remember that shit. Oh, go. You know, it's funny that when you're playing, whatever character you're playing, like... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Chuckle Debuggle told us not to touch the butt. I'm gonna touch the butt!
Don't touch my butt.
Fucking A. Go this
way. Did I
say
I was going to touch your butt, Bliss?
Don't touch my butt!
I'm not gonna touch your butt! Solar might, but I won't.
No.
How the fuck is it that Donkey Kong is able to withstand a polluted are you serious? Withstand a fucking polluted lake. Just... Oh, shit!
You're fine.
Because reasons.
God damn it!
What happened?
I died.
Oh. Okay, I thought for a moment the stream died again.
He was deed. She deed. Lick this if you cry every team.
Ah, oh, Jesus. No. Oh, Jesus.
No.
Oh my God, Will.
That's a thing. That's
what the heck is up with this game?
What were they thinking?
What? So many wheels? Why not four? Jeez, what were they thinking? Make up your minds. Why would you have your character swim in a polluted lake? Wouldn't it be poisoned? Jeez, game designers, get with it.
What a bunch of poopy ass dicks.
This game is a bunch of dick waffles.
Covered in
poo.
I don't want religion in my game.
Why is there a chair with legs running around? Is it in a hurry to get shadowed?
God damn it, you pieces of shit!
You're not pieces of shit,
excuse
squids.
Us?
You
get squid cyst. Squid cyst. Squid cysts. It's like you're racist against squids, and that's also a condition that you can have while you're underwater. Just a squid cyst can just grow inside your anal cavity. You could die in like 30 minutes after.
Oh, damn it!
Speaking of which.
You know, the funny thing I should mention is that despite that both Donkey and Diddy are like in this polluted lake, how is it that the other fish and sharks and squids are surviving this crap? Are they fucking mutated?
I was about
they're
to say,
radioactive.
Like, you know,
radioactive.
No! Don't touch me! Don't touch me!
Don't touch me now! You're gonna burn yourself! Don't touch me now! You're gonna burn yourself!
Oh my fucking God! I ought to have you here more often. Jesus Christ!
I'm not Jesus Christ, I'm Will. Get it right. Do I look like
my Uncle Sam?
Oh, that was close. That was close. That was close. I'm trying to finish this game, and I'm like trying to go carefully, and yet I still get my fucking ass kicked. Go, go,
wait,
down, down, down.
Oh,
shit. No, 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 no. Oh.
That wheel just scraped along by Donkey Kong's penis.
The funny thing is that whichever character you're not playing as, no harm will be inflicted on him.
They're like the ice climbers.
God damn it! Alright, wheel,
so
how far
like
do you go? How far
climbs?
Do you go? It's gonna come back, I know it's gonna come. There it is, there it is. Damn, that was close. Yes! Checkpoint! And I got 3 lives. Cool. Alright, sweet.
You got this.
Is your life counter Donkey Kong's head is a balloon?
Yes, your life counter is a fucking balloon. And have you not played this game before?
No.
You know what we need to do now? You know what we need to do? We need to have Will play this game too.
Yes, this game is amazing. It's great. And I'm not just saying that for the sake of saying it, like,
You're not just bending over and sucking this game's dick.
Oh, no. Like, I disagree with Shigeru Miyamoto, who hated this game. I fucking love it.
Like,
it's not
fun.
Like,
I
don't know if it's top 10 list or not, but still, like, oh, shit, that was close. Yeah, the game is very challenging. It's not the most challenging game, but it's considered, like, one of the toughest games on the, console.
Huh.
Yeah. It's not Super Ghouls and Ghost Heart or God fucking damn wheels!
Now you know how Trixie feels every single day having wheel phobias.
Oh my god, shut the fuck up.
The great and powerful Trixie doesn't trust wheels. It fucked me once. No, bad choice of words. I was raped by wheels!
Wow, even with the amulet on, your inner feeling, your actual inner secrets are, like, still showing. You want to tell something, Trixie?
Wheels don't like Goldie. No, Chad, how about this? If we get 10, then Will should play at least one level.
I want to see Uncle Songhorse
play
a level.
Yes!
What game?
No.
This game.
If they reach 10, they'll have me play a level in this.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, we'll basically be exchanging turds. All right, that's cool. A little bit of a variety here.
If that's what the people's want is.
Oh, shit.
They want Uncle Songhorse to...
What the...
Hey, his name's Uncle Songhorse, not Uncle Game Horse.
Oh, shit.
Uncle Songhorse,
yes.
You get it right, noobs.
Okay. Here's a question for the chat. How many of you have seen the movie Caveman?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Are they aware of the sacred religion of Zug Zug?
Go. Oh, shit, that was close. Oh, shit, there's an arrow. I mean, an arrow sign. That means I'm near the end of the stage. Near the end of the stage. Come the fuck on, let's get through this. Don't get touched by the goddamn fish. Good God, they're everywhere. Holy crap. Oh my God. Are they all gonna rush to get McDonald's?
Well, they're piranhas. They gotta get their protein somehow.
Yes! I'm at the end!
Yay!
And you collapsed.
Shut the fuck up. And I'm going to save. Ugh, Jesus.
Why are you so mean to us?
Like, this is pretty much going to be that one final episode where it may be over an hour, depending how long the stream can last before I can get disconnected again. For those unaware, on YouTube, if you haven't been a part of the stream, the stream has been acting up lately, or my internet's been acting up lately. And here we are, one of these minecart stages. Holy shit, I thought I was... you lose your momentum if you jump in midair after the goddamn minecart falls down the pit. Seriously? Ah, Jesus.
I don't think Will would survive this game.
No, he probably wouldn't. He would probably get frustrated and could probably be angrier than Starlight Glimmer.
Oh my.
You just know my trigger words too well, don't you?
Yep.
Fuck! He says so innocently.
And because we're in this sort of situation, Zach might know this, but.
No! Oh, shit! Oh, oh, damn it! Damn it! Damn it! No! Damn it, bees! Fucking douchebags.
Bees!
My god! No, not the bees! Not the bees! Oh, they're my eyes!
I was about to say, like. Donkey Kong and the minecarts broke free, but ran out of control to the mines below.
Oh, no, fuck off.
Hold on, hold on, faster, faster, said Donkey Kong.
Jesus Christ. And you know what's okay about this? If I die and get a game over, I can pick up right where I last left off. So yeah, fuck Yay. You, game. You thought you could send me back to the beginning to where I last saved? No. Oh, shit.
Uh-oh. There you go.
That was close. That was so fucking close. Okay.
Well, Golden, I have some good news for you.
What's up?
Well, apparently my grandma is having us overnight for friggin' dinner, so I won't be streaming tonight.
Oh. Okay.
I'll have to stream as soon as my dad leaves for work, though.
You know, the funny thing you should mention is that as soon as you announce the news, you get a game over. It's like the game is, like, feeling so bad for you now.
Of course.
Alright, well.
But yeah, you get to stream as much as you want tonight. I won't be over. Bleh. You know.
Bleh.
Well, that might be a good time to, like. Sorry, were you saying something?
Who, me?
Yeah, you were still continuing?
Yeah, I was just going to say, it's like, yeah, you can stream all you want tonight. I kind of have my schedule cleared until tomorrow, I guess.
Alright. That would be a good time, like, if I ever finish Donkey Kong Country, and I have some spare time, I could make one of those one-shot episodes, like, one of which I do Kaizo Mario.
Hmm.
Well, you're aware of that title, right?
I've heard of it, yes.
Let's just say that,
it's, like, one of the hardest Mario games ever, if I'm correct.
Not just that. There's a whole history- Oh, shit! I just missed the checkpoint! Oh my fucking god! What is wrong with me?
You don't even care if you just talk about it.
Let me count.
No! Whatever, I got extra lives. It's all good. But no, Kaizo Mario, yeah, it's known to be it's a Super Mario World ROM hack, and they redesigned the stages where they're so fucking ridiculous that on the first stage, as soon as you begin, you encounter a tall stack of bullet bill cannons blasting right at you.
Is it wrong that with a name like Kaizo Mario, it sounds like one of those Zalgo creepypasta games like Sonic.exe?
It can be a bit of a creepypasta based on someone's rage and frustration. But no, it was a game that somebody made a ROM hack of just to piss their friend off. And a part of which they like to nickname it Asshole Mario. So yeah, damn it! I just missed the checkpoint again. What the fuck?
That's why you don't jump over it.
No, I'm just like, I'm having these crazy reflexes because of all the goddamn vultures and bees. Okay, I didn't jump that time.
Not the bees.
And here we go, back in the 80s with the bananas. Pour some sugar on me. Hey, look, I said 80s.
Sugar on me.
Okay, I gotta wait for it. Fuck you! Sorry. My cart now, bitch. And mine now, bitch.
That was my home, you prick!
Find another one! Get a job!
Get a job!
I'm such an asshole today. Oh my god.
Jeff, you hear me?
Is it wrong they kind of look... For whatever reason, they think they look like Electahounds.
Oh, shit!
Or those, like...
Yes! 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 Woohoo!
Like... God, I'm covered in sweat.
Anyway, you were saying?
I was kind of covered in sweat. I didn't know this game turned you on that much.
Shut the fuck up! Oh my... I can't believe I walked in. Dude, you're worse than Eliora! The shit that you come up with!
The surprises
I
you
think
how,
Uncle Sockhart's been hanging out with us too much.
Okay, I know how random and silly you can be, but sexually, oh fuck, this is gonna be a pain in the ass, isn't it? Well, why am I not surprised? Well, why should I be surprised? Is the better question.
Exactly, you shouldn't. This is you're gonna. How long do you plan on being a roommate of mine?
No, I'm talking about this fucking stage. I mean, no. Back to what I was saying. Fucking A. No, like, I know how random and silly you are, but to get, like, to get frickin' NSFW or to get this loot and crass?
Oh, you have no fucking idea, dude.
I'm not even... I shouldn't ask.
Don't
I shouldn't...
Yeah, don't. Do it. Just don't.
It's walked into other territory. Oh, shit!
Fox, my man, Rotato Chip, Poseidon, Brosephine. When I first met Will, he was not a lewd motherfucker. He was an innocent little cinnamon roll, and then he met Wooten, and then it all turned to shit.
Oh no!
Yeah,
no.
If I recall,
even back then, when he first met me, I just decided not to show it.
If I recall, I believe Peter, aka Aeon, told me that. Golden Fox has always been very, very lewd. He just tends to reserve himself now these days.
No, like, the funny thing is that when I first met Peter, that was when I started to become more open and becoming crass myself, but not to the public like this until, you know, Tetris.
Are those enemies that you're crushing, are they, like...
They're wearing military helmets.
Not just that, it almost looked like they were showing off their tits.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Crocodile boobies. Hashtag crocodile boobies.
I guess.
No, I'll give you one better, Fox. Hashtag croc titties.
Oh! Yep. Wooten changed them forever.
Bullshit.
Oh, dear. I think Keyframe and A and Y are watching the stream right now. Fox.
What's up?
Key and A and Y are in the stream.
Oh
really?
Hi, Key!
Oh,
hey, babe, how's Germany?
Hey, how y'all doing?
Oh, shit. Okay.
The fact that Key just, I don't know, one of the first things she shows up to is crocodiles.
Oh my god, are you fucking serious?
Like, what? What the actual fuck? I feel so bad.
No. It was one of those orangutans that like to throw those barrels. I'm looking carefully. Okay, there they are. Woo! Wow, just knocked them all over like a bunch of bowling pins. Okay, you were saying? Ow!
Oh, I was just saying, like, you know, just... Never mind.
Go eat. Babe, what did I do?
You never asked.
Look what you did, Fox. You made A and Y cry.
Are you shitting me? Did I seriously make the German cry?
He's probably just trolling you. It's A and Y.
No.
Okay. What triggered that?
Golden Bully. What?
Golden Bully. Wow.
Babe, how would you like to join the call?
Also, I found Key in the nutshell.
Was that a toilet?
Who's...
Apparently!
Where's that coming from?
Oh, would you look at that.
Must have been from Lissazund.
Whoa, shit. Alright, so, what does this dude have to do?
Behold, Donkey Kong's own version of Flops.
Flops? What?
No, Flops.
Oh, yeah. This is like the first time I've seen, like, one of these- Are you shitting me?! No,
Well, the barrel is literally shitting on you, so...
It's shitting enemies. It's like, I really should have had that fourth burrito today.
Why did everything adjusting these crocodile
I will be pissed. I will be pissed off at you if it shits out one of those blue, muscular guys that Diddy can't stand.
Is that anymore. A fucking barrel?
Oh!
Holy shit, that's a death barrel.
No shit!
Bliss, would you mind muting your mic?
What did you got rid of the snakes?
Snakes.
Why did it have to be snakes? I hate snakes.
Bliss, would you mind muting next time you're gonna do loud stuff in the background?
Yeah.
I didn't know y'all could hear that. Sorry.
Oh, shit. Yeah, we can hear everything.
Shit. Okay.
Yes, Bliss, we can hear everything.
So play nice. Okay, that's the part that fooled me.
Add A and Y to
Damn
the
it.
Call.
Son
okay.
of a bitch!
Should we?
That depends on Fox.
What's up?
Add A and Y to the call?
Yes! I was asking earlier if both he, like, either he or Key.
Please?
Yeah.
Let's see. A and Y.
Add Z and Y.
Was that you?
I just added him.
I just heard a key.
No? That's
what?
Me.
No, I think it was Sappy.
Oh. How did I get mixed up with those two voices?
Hello!
Hi.
Hello?
Hello?
Is that the German or is that the red-haired Italian?
red-haired Italian.
Wow!
This is marinara sauce. How are you doing?
Red-haired Italian. Key, is there something you're not telling us? Are you part Italian? I didn't know that.
Yeah! She's part Italian and Hungarian. And I just yes, in your face. In your face. Okay, you know what? Just to make sure that I save my work. Come on, all the way to the beginning. I'm gonna find a save point. I'm gonna fuel up on lives so that way I can make any, like, some progress and hopefully beat this fucking game.
You never beat it before, I'm assuming?
No, I beat it before. It's just that every time I was streaming this, I've made, like, this has the most amount of effort. What the hell was I thinking? I'm supposed to find a save point, not a barrel flight. I went on autopilot, whatever. Not the end of the world. Alright. There. And everyone's silent.
Oh.
I'm here. I'm just listening.
I was waiting for Key to talk, so.
Yeah.
Oh, guys, Max sent me a message.
Oh boy, what did he send?
What, you mean he's not with you?
Hold on, let me get the message.
I'm good too, thanks for asking.
What? I didn't catch what
he said.
He said
I'm good too, thanks for asking.
He said I'm good too, thanks for asking.
Where is he?
Is he not
bully?
With you?
Asleep. I don't know.
Why would he be with me? I mean, like...
Because you... Two are literally
you're living
in
his room.
Right now.
Uh-huh, yeah, totally.
Damn it. I didn't reach that one. Whatever.
Oh, wait, he sent me another message.
Oh, boy.
I am totally far away. Nobody knows where I am.
A huge just avalanche of snow just fell off my roof. How nice.
Oh yeah, are you in that big snowstorm that's happening right now?
Oh no,
it was yesterday, but yeah.
Well, I know in the Northeast they got like 20 inches of snow, so.
Pretty much, yeah.
Who's eating?
Yeah, that's Bliss.
Bliss. I'm being an angel Blissy, right now since
Blissy,
it's
eat your Lucky Charms somewhere else.
Keep getting my ass.
It's ranch Doritos. Thank you very much.
That
don't eat while you're chewing.
Oh boy.
So I have a question for Key while she's here. What did Golden do that would make A and Y like cry or something? What?
Well, okay, let's talk about the reasons why Golden is such a golden bully. He asked me how Germany is, but you never see him go to ANY being like, gee willikers, ANY, how is Germany for you, buddy? No, you never ask how Germany is for the German. You know how he must feel? He doesn't feel that special anymore that he lives in Germany because no one ever asks him how he feels. That's
well,
why
with all due respect, when...
So basically he was trolling us.
I'm gonna take that silence as a yes.
Wait, no, what did you say?
Will said.
Yeah, so basically, he's just being A and Y in a little trolley fart butt muncher.
Oh, wait, A and Y sent a new message.
Oh, boy.
Oh, God.
Okay, hold on. Let me play it.
My little German heart is totally broken.
Look what you did, Golden!
Oh my fucking god, NY!
You know who has to comfort him? Me! You know whose sleeve he uses as a tissue? Mine! Who's dry cleaning? Who's the one who pays the dry cleaning bill? Not him! How long have you been playing this game?
I mean in your life,
Golden. It seems like every other stream is Donkey Kong Country.
That's because I haven't finished the game yet, and to answer your question, I think this is the 8th episode.
You need to play a more fulfilling game, like Tetris.
babe, do you want me to tell you stories? Do you want me to gather around a campfire?
Me and Max watched the Tetris stream. Guys, stop pulling. Lissy, one day the poor girl's gonna have an aneurysm. Her heart is not as young as it used to be.
And yet, apparently I'm a glutton for punishment because I told him when my computer comes back, I'd be willing to do it again.
She wants to compete with me.
I think you shaved like 7 years off her life, and you know how long that is in horse years? And how longer that is in YouTuber horse years?
I was about to say, she almost called me short there.
Well, horses live a long time, let's be fair.
But, okay.
How have you been, Key?
How have I been?
Well, I've been alive, at least from the last time that I checked.
Yay!
Please tell me you're having fun, you're getting to see the sights, you're getting some air, you're sleeping.
Okay, what's the weather like down there? I'm actually kind of curious.
See, I would say... Oh, wait, look, I got a new message from ANY.
Oh my fucking god.
Really?
She is actually sleeping for the first time in her life.
She actually is sleeping.
How would he know this is my question.
Because you two are living in the same apartment?
Hey, look, ANY's been here the whole time.
No, I haven't.
Oh, so what are you just? Are you just the voice in my head, or am I just doing a really good ANY impression right now?
Obviously, a voice in your head.
Yeah. Because if I could do that good of an ANY impression, well, I just wouldn't need you for collabs anymore. I would just record my vocals for you.
That's pretty much what you did for the last 3 years.
But yes, Bliss, I've been having a good time.
Yay!
God. We actually, on my birthday, we went to there's a Sony Center in the city of Berlin.
Are you serious? We just got disconnected from the call. Hang on, let me try to get back in.
No!
We got disconnected.
There we go.
Just got kicked out of the call.
Well, now
you're here.
Well, obviously the call realized how big of a bully you are, Brett, and decided.
Wow.
Golden, the next vector you do of your OC, you should have it look like a schoolyard bully with like, and use the ANY puppet you made for the upcoming thing, and make him look all sad and scared, and just be like, "Give me your lunch money," backwards cap and jeans and stuff.
Make him look like Spurg from Billy and Mandy. Because why not? I don't know.
But yeah.
Okay,
so.
Now I got plenty of lives. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Oh, ANY sent me a new message. I wonder if it is.
Also, don't forget to tell them about all the great traditional German food you ate, like Kentucky Fried Chicken, like hamburgers,
like... Oh, it's American food!
For some reason.
Well, okay, he better have taken you out for schnitzel and bratwurst al dente.
No, better. You. I'm surprised you haven't been having this. What happened to the good old Wiener schnitzel?
Oh God, stop!
Wien is in Austria, you buffoon.
Still in the same vicinity of Europe.
Ah, fuck.
Okay.
Dude, you're getting this all mixed up. That's like thinking like Mexicans and Puerto Ricans are the same thing. They're not fucking racist.
Right there. Okay, Max, even Lars took me out for schnitzel, okay?
No, well...
But he said specifically Wiener schnitzel.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's different.
No, okay, let me tell you guys about German Kentucky Fried Chicken.
German Kentucky... Oh, I'm listening to this. Okay.
So this was the first day that I got here, and I wanted to get some dinner. So, and we had to go to the hardware store. I'm not going to give context on why we went to the hardware store. But, we stopped at a Kentucky Fried Chicken. First of all, it was decently clean. First sign that this is not an American Kentucky Fried Chicken. Second, they had French fries. And I thought that was one of the most off-putting things that I've ever seen, is a pile of French fries with Kentucky Fried Chicken. Also, they still have the KFC Double Down.
Oh my God, those are like obsolete over here. What the hell?
For people in the audience who don't know what a KFC Double Down is, first of all, good for you. You probably have working arteries. Second of all, imagine a chicken sandwich, but instead of it being two buns, it's just two giant pieces of chicken with cheese and bacon inside of it.
Yes, what's your?
Okay, even with bacon, that just sounds like you're asking for, like, a fucking heart attack.
I know, that's why I bought it.
Are you crazy?
Yes. No, here's the thing. Even with the KFC Double Down, even with the fact they have French fries, I bet it's still probably healthier than the ones that we have in America because their batter was different and it tasted better. Germans make better Kentucky Fried Chicken than the country that made Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Wow.
Oh, you better not say that to Bucky.
But,
Wait, is Bucky in Kentucky?
Yeah!
But yeah, so I did not know that. So besides that, we got hamburgers another day. Really good. But there was this thing that happened outside of the hamburger place with the little kid.
Oh.
Do you want to tell this one?
I'm not entirely sure if I can describe it properly. There was this very tiny child, 1 year,
A toddler.
A toddler, basically. Could walk on two legs, barely. And he was going out of the door in front of me. And there was this one step stair.
Yeah.
And he just stood there. And put his hands in front of him and just like in slow motion fell over forward and crashed to the ground
on top of his hamburger. The thing, it wasn't like he tripped here. It wasn't like he physically tripped. He just was standing there and then he was on the ground. There was like this long pause. There was like this 3 second pause before he actually started screaming. Like, and then me and Max are kind of just standing there looking down, being like, where's this kid's dad? Like, I mean, the guy came quickly, but it was still just like, I had to hold back laughing because the situation was so ridiculous. I was kind of beside myself with laughter.
And I was just hoping that he wouldn't get the idea that I had kicked the child over because I had left right after them.
Kick the baby!
Don't kick the baby!
Bounce
the goddamn pit. Great job.
And
right?
Yeah, the final food place was actually a nice place. After we went to go see Lego Batman, we were trying to find a place to eat. And we were trying to find a place around the Sony Center. We thought we found a Chinese restaurant.
Oh.
It turned out to be a bank.
Check her Twitter. She took images of it.
All right, let me go on Key's Twitter. My God.
But no, like the top part of it had like Chinese letters, so we thought, oh, it's a Chinese restaurant. Then we looked at the door and it said,
Bank
China, Berlin branch. And we're like, oh.
Oh, would you look at that? Hey, babe, your sister's here.
Wait, my sister?
Lauren, she's watching.
Oh. Abby.
Oh, hi, it's the Abby. Rosie. Yep.
It's the Muckle Mare.
But no, we eventually found this, like, place that's actually relatively close. We found this place that was relatively close to where Max actually lives. That was this Italian Greek place, really nice. But we were not the demographic of people there. They kind of got put into the back where it was really quiet and nice.
First of all, it was the same building as an old people home, and even so. The people visiting this place have been younger than the people I assume living in the building.
They were like 40s, 50s.
Yeah, we still kind of raised the age thingy there. Also, you got another message.
Oh, cool.
Okay, I found the picture.
Nice to see you again.
Fuck.
I guess.
That definitely says Chinese bank.
Yeah, Sapphire, shut up for a second.
Hi, Lauren. Nice to see you again.
Oh, look, Lauren, you got a personalized message from ANY.
And it didn't cost you anything at all.
He sounds so enthused to see you again.
He is literally just phoning these in right now.
God, I mean, yeah. But no, so this weekend we're actually going to go see Moana. Because here's the thing.
Yay.
I thought that Moana was done in theaters until I went to go look up the list.
Yeah, not many people, like, okay, well, as far as, like, movies that hit the theaters go, when it, like, when it's there for a little while, most people assume that it's not in theaters anymore. I think, theoretically, they're still in theaters until they're out of video. What?
Brett, listen very carefully. Do you hear that noise? It's the sound of silence. Maybe you should listen to it.
Oh my god, Chrissy, you're so mean.
Jeez.
And you think I was the bully. Okay, hashtag keyframe bully.
Okay. No, a bully frame, first of all. If you're going to insult me, use it right.
God, bully, I have the urge to tell you to not do those crazy jumps, but I realize that the stream is like a minute delayed or something, and you're...
Oh, yeah. I forgot about share screening. Hang on, let me fix
that.
No, either way, I was looking up to see the show times for Split. Because I was like, okay, if Moana's not in theaters, then this cool horror movie would be good. That's not in theaters anymore. But then I was looking up stuff, and apparently they are showing Moana, but only like once a week. at like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I'm like, whatever, we are going to see Moana.
Then again, we are talking about the English version, so...
Well, yeah. I mean, they only screened it in English at this place.
Really?
Well, yeah, because, I mean, the other theater that's closer to here, they screened it, but it was only in German, you said?
You lucky duck. There is no theater anywhere near my husband's hometown that plays anything in English.
Well, you have to remember this is in the city of Berlin, like
y'all
middle.
Are in the great big capital of Berlin.
Shit. Oh my god.
What's it, Potsdamer Platz or whatever?
Potsdamer.
Yes. So. Whoa. When we went to see Lego Batman, because that was being screened in English, there was surprisingly a good amount of English-speaking families that were there. Not a lot. I mean, it wasn't like a filled movie theater, but it was still there. But Lego Batman is still great the second time around. Hey, Will, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
I got a question for you.
Oh, God.
What's up?
What was your favorite scene from the Lego Batman movie?
That's a good question.
That is a good question. Pretty much the entire beginning segment. Up until pretty much the entire beginning of that, and especially when Batman is doing nope, waka, nope.
See,
by the way, yes, this is spoilers.
See, Will, I'm waiting for you to do a cover of the I'm Batman song that was in the beginning of that movie.
Oh, that was the best thing.
Yes! That's an idea.
That is an idea. I don't know,
man. Oh, fuck!
Maybe. That
I want to see you too.
Come on, get on, Rhino. There
The one off-putting thing about seeing the Lego Batman movie again was before that, I was marathoning BoJack Horseman.
Nice.
And BoJack, the voice of BoJack, is the same guy who voices Batman in the movie. So when I hear the voice, it's Will Arnett. So.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Damn it.
Oh, yeah. If you want to watch a good show that will depress you, watch BoJack Horseman.
I know. It is. It's so interesting, yet so depressing at the same time.
Right.
The level of depression pretty much depends on who you identify with.
If you identify with BoJack, you're not going to have a good time.
Goodbye, yeah, Randy. Pretty much I fell into a few day-long depressions each time a season ended. And not because the season ended, but because of the ending of the season. Okay. He was like, oh, yeah, it's a good show, dark a few times, but reasonable. And I was like, okay,
who do I identify with? And I said, oh, Todd and Princess Carolyn. And he was like, yeah, see, that's why you didn't get the voice.
Huh.
But Todd is played by the guy who played Jesse in Breaking Bad, and it's great.
Damn it!
Science, bitch!
Hooray!
Huzzah!
Miscarriage! But there's a character in the show, Will, I think you'd really like. His name is Mr. Peanut Butter.
My god. I fucking love Mr. Peanut Butter. I hated him in the first season, but then afterwards I was like, you are my favorite character now.
Yeah, pretty much keep him doing the first two episodes, like, Mr. Peanut Butter, you compared me to Princess Caroline, I don't know if I like those characters.
And then I watched it, I'm like, oh my god, you're right.
Who's that dog? Mr. Peanut Butter!
Okay.
But no, in the beginning of the show, I was like, oh, see, I don't really like Princess Carolyn or Mr. Peanut Butter, but I like Diane, and I like Todd. By the end of it, it was like, I love Princess Mr. Peanut Butter and Carolyn, I hate Diane, Todd is still awesome.
Well, Diane also changed in her defense.
The only consistent thing in the show that I liked was Todd. Well, I mean, liked in the... I really like the character. Not the show went bad or anything.
Quick question, Fox. Haven't you already done this level? What are you doing back at the beginning?
No. Have you never heard of Groundhog Day?
You saw that mist? That wasn't there before. I know.
Well,
you're
aren't you near the end of the game? I thought he was near the beginning of the game. I guess it was just me.
Oh, by the way, Blissey is here, isn't she?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes.
So we basically go into stereo moaning if Goldie continues playing Tetris. Because when we watched his Let's Play, it was basically you and I moaned at the same time and did the same, like, the left.
I had to leave the room because I was getting so annoyed at how some of his Tetris thingy was going on.
What?
It took every fiber of my being not to pull all my eyebrows out.
it was like at first we were like, okay, I don't see why Bliss is freaking out. Then me and A and Y just started to go, come on, Brett.
it's not fun being OCD. It's not fun being OCD. It really isn't.
Well, says the one who wants to do another stream of Tetris.
It's not easy being a masochist either, but we still do it.
Apparently, I am a little bit of a masochist. Because you gotta admit that the conversations we have were hilarious. Even Lars was laughing his ass off when he listened.
See, the thing is, I'm not particularly OCD. But the main video game that I grew up playing was Tetris, because I had three versions of the game on my Game Boy Advance.
Okay.
Yeah, because I had two normal Tetris games, and then I had this like Pac-Man compilation. see you check your Twitter. Okay, I'll check my Twitter.
Poopy lights. Oh boy.
But no, like, check. There was this Game Boy Advance cartridge that I had that I kept for years, and it was this compilation of Pac-Man games, and one of it was Pac Attack, which is basically Pac-Man Tetris.
Nice. Now, my mother, my grandmother, and my second eldest sister, they were the Tetris queens. They were extremely competitive. These days, since my grandmother is too far gone, that sort of thing, my mother and I are the competitive ones, so we like to challenge each other. The Tetris I have is the old one from the Nintendo. And as far as I can tell, it only goes up to level 9. My mom surpassed me by one level, and I'm like... So here's Goldie, and he surpassed me over level 8. And I'm like, okay, either he just showed me up, or my game won't allow me to go any higher. It's one of the two. But yeah, Ellie says she's gone to level 13 or 14, so I'm like, okay... it is on like Donkey Kong.
I don't see the thing is I don't know why, but I remember the first time that I played Tetris was actually because I was in counseling for a lot of the first developmental years of my life, elementary school, and the way to calm me down when I was having like breakdowns and attacks was that my counselor would put on Tetris and I would be so focused on that I would forget my emotions.
I've been hearing that Tetris has been very therapeutic even for non-gamers.
Mm-hmm.
I actually believe that.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
once
those
again,
kinds of
thank the Russians.
I mean, those kinds of games. You know, in times like these, I don't think saying thank the Russians on the internet is really a great thing to say.
Not to mention, the Russians also developed Monopoly, which has the intention to be absolutely anything but calming, so...
Monopoly is the board game version of Mario.
2.5 hours in the game of Monopoly. Fuck this game! It's 4 a.m, Grandma! You win!
See, the thing is, we used to play Monopoly a lot with my family, and Monopoly is like the board game version of Mario Party in that it ruins friendships and family.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Except that's Monopoly is fucking boring.
I'll agree to that, too.
Not when you're someone who did whose main things in life is counting money and learning about economic stuff.
So it's basically banker porn.
Banker porn, I love that.
I love playing Tetris, though.
Who doesn't love playing Tetris? Your life, so.
Not worth it. Shit, how do I get past this? Okay, wait for it.
Oh, I
jump
just wanted
over. There we go. Oh, come on!
Wow!
The platform below me.
Looks like you're worth.
How many levels is in this game?
Shut the fuck up,
Brett.
Yes.
Question. How many levels are in this game?
What?
How many levels are in this game?
A lot. I'm almost done. Like after I'm like through with this, I can face King K. Krool, and then the game will be done.
Yay!
So I'm like 90% in. It's just that these last stretches are a pain in the ass. And that damn ostrich just knocked like one of those freaking nuts on, like, off. Ugh.
That's not how you say it. I thought it was focusing. King K. Rool.
What?
I thought it was King K. Rool.
Yeah, that's what I said.
No, you
oh,
said-
wait, no. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm thinking King K. Rool. Never mind.
Oh, what? I was right on the edge. How could he fall through the platform? That was bullshit.
I don't know, but you just did. Yeah, exactly.
Shut the fuck up, Will. Shut the fuck up.
No.
You will never silence the Uncle Song Horse.
We will not be silenced.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
And they booped the Goldilocks.
Absolute focus. How do I get up there? Oh, there we go. Fuck you. Fuck
no,
you,
that's eavesdrop.
Why would you want to fuck with their bees?
Okay, first of all, I wasn't bees that I was encountering. Second of all, that's not what I meant.
Are you sure about that?
Oh my.
No.
Indeed.
Fuck no. That's. Don't you dare. I know what you're gonna do. Don't you fucking dare.
They call it the birds and the bees for a reason, so.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And you already have, and you already have.
Will!
Hey, don't you like eat wing robot chicken.
Hang on, let Key speak, you were saying?
No, I was just gonna say, you already have a bird on your ass, Golden. A bee is just the second part of the equation.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Isn't it great to hear my voice again, sweetie?
Yes, it is.
We've missed you.
We miss you.
And I, well, anyway, back to the game.
And
wow.
I will always love you.
Bliss, I've lost your mind.
Ha!
I went over the pit. Oh, shit. Ha. How about that?
Like,
yeah, you want to continue throwing barrels, orangutan?
You are going to get your ass kicked in 3, 2, 1.
Ha! How about that, you piece of shit?
Okay, maybe right about.
Nope.
Whoa! That one last guy tried to fuck
you. You thought you could outsmart me. No, I rused you. Save.
You lose! Good day, sir!
And there goes the call once again. Being a complete POS. Okay.
I will always love you.
So, yeah. The internet's been a little wonky lately.
So,
okay.
So there was something that, Me and Max Marathon the other night. We watched literal music, literal versions of different songs. Have you guys ever seen the literal lyrics for Total Eclipse of the Heart? It's great. The best.
The first literal music video I ever watched was for Billie Jean.
Oh yeah, that's what we watched that one too. My lover. The thing was that the best ones are the 80s music videos because they're so stupid. But yeah. we saw the one with Billie Jean, Take On Me, Total Eclipse of the Heart.
And we saw the reverse thing where somebody took a song the way it literally was and made a video to it.
With Bicycle by Queen. Bicycle, I want to ride my bicycle.
Bicycle.
Yeah, but someone took the song. Okay. Took the song and made a literal video for it, which I think that was pretty ingenious.
You know what? I actually think I need to check that out. Bicycle Race literal sounds hilarious because even the original song itself, it's just silly.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me look it up for you.
But that's the beauty of Queen. Queen has so much fun with their music that even when they have fun with it, they make it fucking epic.
Well, if you're gonna be silly and have that much money, expendable income, you might as well go big or go home.
Go home.
It's a question if you want to put it on the stream.
I don't know if you can get copyright for that.
I mean, I believe it has nothing on. Well, it's actually music now, isn't it? So, oh yeah, there you go.
Of course Queen is the best EG Studios 93.
What do you in your face?
There are bands that are better than Queen. Well, yes, that is true, because even a sexually ambiguous man like Freddie Mercury knew what made the world go round.
Okay, I just got an update of some kind. Hang on a second. Thank you for following Mark Rourke.
Mark Rourke, I think.
Mark.
Shut up, Blissey.
How can you tell about Blissey?
Because Blissey's a chicken.
I am not a chicken. I am drawing a banana, a Blissey split.
Walk, 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 I'm a chicken.
Good for you, Sapphire. Walk.
No, I'm trying to do the friggin' amethyst scene from, what was it, log date, two, I forget the numbers.
I don't know what you speak of.
This is why I failed statistics. I don't do numbers.
Oh, Steven, did you see the newest episode?
Oh, yes, I did.
That Ruby is terrifying.
I know! Oh my god.
I saw that episode. Hey, I'm like, what
you
the
mean
fuck?
To tell me you weren't
Something's
following
wrong.
Me before? How could you?
See, I got a great explanation for that. I live with you, so I don't think I need to follow you because I can hear you across the hall.
She's got a point.
I even followed you, and we were like,
well, you know,
together.
Well, you know what, Brett?
That sounds like a personal problem.
But no, see, this is the one. The one thing I will say, I'm glad that Ruby went back to homeworld because I don't think I could stand her voice for more than one episode.
I love rain and flowers and dirt. I love rain. I love pumpkin. I could have. I wanted to see the look on your face when your favorite Ruby betrayed you!
Wow, I hate this character already.
It's like all the other Rubies sound fine, but she has to be like this!
And Rainbow Day, always dresses in style!
Oh, stop it.
Dear God.
I prefer Leggy over all the other Rubies.
Leggy barely talked! Is that the point?
Oh, thank you for
not really. I meant like Leggy was just
bucks.
Adorable
Thanks,
and
Thanks,
oblivious, and I loved her.
Oh, she was the one that was like,
Shit!
Oh,
you bitch!
Wasted the barrel on the wasp you already
so
passed to let the giant stand in front of you.
Anyway, I'm gonna slow up, guys.
Yeah, Leggy was just the one that was adorably oblivious to everything. Well, why didn't you say so?
Yes, it was.
Alright, I'm heading off. Take care, guys.
Alright, later, Will.
Bye, Will!
Okay.
Wait, where's Will going?
The store.
Yeah, he's going back to work on some of his projects.
Oh.
Yeah, so
annoy him! Knock on his door! Hit the wall! You can do this now, you're roommates!
Would you do it?
Yeah.
Of course you would.
But that's mostly because I have... But that's mostly because I have no respect for everyone else's personal space.
Wow.
Well, yes. Then, our roommate, we would have to conjure a roommate agreement like Sheldon Cooper in the Big Bang Theory.
I think that's called a wall.
Oh, shit. That was close. Okay.
Wall
shit.
No.
Damn it.
You don't screw
what,
the roommate agreement.
Like
the roommate agreement screws you.
Then there'd be Bliss like going... Kiki.
There we go.
I swear, if Blissey did that, she would get. I would be kicking her in the face, and it would be like, Blissey.
Nope. Chrissy.
Oh my god, I would. That needs to be a gag for a video or something.
You're welcome.
No. It should be like Key tries to knock on Bliss's door to try to get in, and she's like, no, do it the way we practice. Come on, Bliss.
No, you do it the way we practice.
Blissey.
There we go.
Blissey.
See, I was hear that... a knock.
Oh my god. I think at that point I would just blast your fucking door down.
Everybody else. Saffy. Saffy.
Oh,
no,
that show.
No, Bliss, see, I actually had an idea for if we ever do a magic lesson, what the opening would be. The opening would be I'd be walking down the hallway, and like Golden, Zach, and A&Y would just be sitting in the hallway eating popcorn. It's like, what are you guys doing? Watching the free light show. What do you mean free light? And it's just a bunch of lasers coming out of your door.
you died, didn't you?
You guys didn't mean to check on her? Well, we were, but this looks too cool.
Golden, do yourself a favor and stop dying.
You make it sound easier.
Make it sound like he has a choice.
What?
Hey, Key, I have to ask you.
Yes?
What do you think of the Donkey Kong Country TV series?
God fucking damn it.
I never watched it, but I've seen clips, and Donkey Kong has a nice singing voice, but I don't think that's a good thing. It's probably, it's just, besides the bad animation, it's just like any other video game adaptation cartoon.
Oh, just think about Captain N.
Okay, Captain N was funny in all the wrong ways.
Also,
I mean, the only good video game TV show that I think I've ever seen that's based on actual video game is the Sonic Boom cartoon.
What about 7
I enjoy the Sonic Boom cartoon now that it's figured out the fact that it wants to be self-aware and just poke fun at everything now.
Well, that's when shows usually get good.
Yes!
Yay!
The second thing that I wanted to bring to your attention, do you know what came out recently?
You from the closet?
I've been out of the closet for like
that's
ages. Anyway.
Sorry. You set up the joke, and I had to chop down the tree. What came out recently?
The Jetsons meet WWE movie.
Oh, that sounds lovely. Are you Nikki and Calcos watching it anytime soon?
I was actually gonna ask. Do you want in on it?
Oh, damn it!
I have a long silence.
I'm gonna answer that question with a question, Zach.
Yeah?
If I was able to embody your childhood and put it in a jar and then had a mallet which to crush it with, would you want me to have you sit and witness it as I crush your childhood with a mallet?
So here's the thing. I never watched the Jetsons, so...
I'm coming up with something proportional. Please don't make me watch this. I know you guys need your token person who watched old cartoons as they're living, but...
But listen, you sat through the Flintstones one, though.
That one was funny. Look, as long as you don't make me watch the Surf's Up one, I'm fine.
Oh, we already reviewed the Surf's Up one. It's the strange thing about the Surf's Up one, Surf's Up 2 Wave Mania, is that it is the least worst out of all of the animated ones. Dare I say it's the best least worst one out of all.
That's not saying much of anything. Uh-huh.
Dude, you're about to die. Go back to level one. Yes.
Yeah. Frustration. That's all.
But I was gonna say, I actually plan to grab Nikki to do it, because Calco said he's not doing it, and I'm like, but Calco's, no, fuck you, and I'm like, okay.
Okay, when do you plan on doing this? Are we doing it at Babs, or whatever?
At Babs.
Okay.
Wait a minute, I thought we were doing Sharknado and Care Bears of Wonderland.
Well,
see, you guys can enjoy those on your own. Because there's going to be plenty of time Key can't be around because Key has stuff to do at the con.
Last life, exactly. Last life, be careful.
But, no, I guess, sure, we can do it at Babs. I'll suffer through it for my friendship.
Okay, because you're familiar. You're, of course, familiar with the Jetsons. I know nothing about it.
Of course I'm familiar with the Jetsons. I'm familiar with anything that's an old cartoon.
Gotcha.
What are you, a nostalgia chick?
No, because I'm not. And I don't have pigtails, and I'm not a distaff counterpart of someone else.
Have you ever considered pigtails?
Come on.
Not since first grade.
No, go down. There we go.
I think she'll consider it when you decide to put red dimples on blue cheeks.
I'm not becoming Raggedy Ann!
Is there something you don't like about Raggedy Ann?
No, I just... I remember that when the reason why I stopped wearing pigtails in the first grade was because people called me Raggedy Ann.
Oh.
Oh.
The main characters that I would get compared at when I was a kid was Velma, Raggedy Ann, and Junie B. Jones from those old children's books.
Oh, what about Pippi Longstocking?
Fuck
yeah. Pippi Longstocking is coming into me.
I've never heard of Pippi Longstocking.
You've never heard of Pippi Longstocking?
All right.
No. Okay, See, Max, if I said that I haven't heard of it, why would I have heard of the German opening for it?
Translated to English?
All right, finally, the moment of truth. Finally facing King K. Krool.
There we go.
Yep.
Hey, Rule, you freaking pleb.
King Krool.
Birch, don't worry. If I get a game over, I can just pick up right where I last left off.
This reminds me of the frickin'... It reminds me of the JonTron thing. I think it was the song from Stairfax Temperatures.
Oh, you mean Star Fox?
Stairfax Temperatures, yeah.
You refuse to call it by its actual name, or yeah. Won't you?
Alright.
It's bad. It's a bad Star Fox game. It's not even a Star Fox game. It's Star Fox meets Legend of fucking Zelda.
Oh,
didn't that come with, like, the blue chick that everyone became a furry over?
Yeah.
Crystal.
Yeah,
Crystal.
It did.
That was my introduction to furryism.
Mine was Renamon.
Wow.
Mine was Basil. What? Nothing is sexier than a British mouse.
That's true.
Alright, here we go.
Better Lola Bunny from Space.
Do we know Jeff Persona yet?
Gonna be another set of cannonballs falling down. There we go.
Oh no!
So keyframe, basically
oh,
you are.
Oh come on! That was
I would assume it would be a cat.
But keyframe, if Jet or the British Ninja's persona would turn out to be a mouse, you would basically have the hots for him. Is this what you're saying?
No.
Oh my.
Actually, no. Speaking of which, key.
It's not over yet.
You know what the weird part is that you mentioned, like, Basil? My grandmother knew the artist who, or not the artist, the author who wrote the books.
Yeah, his name is Arthur Conan Doyle.
Eve, do it.
Ow!
Oh, hey, he beat the game.
No,
not yet.
Not yet.
It was like fake credits.
Question mark.
I forgot he does that. It's been a really long time since I played this game. There we go. Now run to the other end.
Oh, shit.
Throw your stupid-ass crown for whatever reason you decide to throw it. And run it back and forth. Throw your crown. Run around back and forth again.
I am so fucking hyped for Season 7 of MLP. Can't wait to see it during BabsCon.
Yeah.
It's so fun.
A thing?
Hmm?
Is this show still a thing?
Yes.
Yes.
I don't...
Oh,
no,
shit.
Spoilers.
Forgot.
No, I'm not going to spoil anything. Don't worry.
But no, I mean, like... See, you guys are such children watching the first show. Me and Max adult things, like read fanfiction.
Indeed. Also, we watched the horse show for adult people.
Oh, I jumped way too fucking soon.
Is that, instead of bronies, we're bogeys.
That sounds so wrong.
Man,
you're so
wrong. Gotcha.
Your face is so wrong.
Oh, your face is so wrong.
He just jumped on a crown.
Oh, ladies, you're both lovely.
I'm watching the wrong stream again, dammit, I'm a minute late.
What?
It's on the screenshot. Oh.
I'm
open, but I'm just watching the wrong one.
It's an immediately high momentum. Jesus Christ.
I'm trying to watch the chat and... Okay, there's
Susan. How have you been doing, chat? I hope you've all been entertained by this.
Are you not entertained? Who's
Glimmer Alchemist?
I like how he just looks to the screen like, oh?
I heard that.
Oh, god damn it!
Oh, it hit your pinky toe.
No! You got hit by a bomb.
Oh, that was close. Again, yep.
Whoop.
We can't
got
send
this.
Buckle to buckle.
Yep.
You're on your own.
That's right, fuck you. Here he goes, jumping right to the end of the ship, and in come the cannonballs. These things are fucking ginormous.
But really, though, I'm glad that you've been having a good time over in Germany, Key. You deserve it.
Yay!
Mm-hmm. I'm definitely having a good time.
Fuck!
And right after this good time, I get to have another good time at PapsCon with you crazy nuts.
Yay!
Oh,
are you still
God.
Doing Disney?
I went right
Well, yeah, I learned before that, so...
Okay.
Oh, God. I think I just scarred Geeky for life.
How?
I told him not to look it up, but he did anyway. It's a certain miscolored breakfast that is actually something else that you shouldn't be looking at.
Oh, you showed him blue waffle.
I didn't show him. I told him not to look it up.
That's reverse psychology 101.
That is reverse psychology 101.
No, Max, no.
Yep, look what you've done. This is all on you.
Well,
this is all your fault.
When Max looked it up, it just showed normal blue.
Oh! Okay,
yeah, there it is.
There it is.
Do I want to know?
No, Fox,
no, you don't
want to
know. Like, Kiki's telling me, like, you know, he said, oh yeah, it seemed worse, whatever. And then, like, hours and hours later, aka now, he's like, I take back what I said about the thing, and I'm just like, I told you not to look it up. March 16th, 2006.
Sapphire, shush. What were you gonna say, Max?
Brett, remember, don't look up blue waffle.
Oh,
remember,
God!
Reverse psychology 101, dude.
Don't do it.
Well, also,
fuck!
If you're going to look it up, don't look it up on stream. Or else you will get banned on Twitch.
Yeah.
Okay,
so this is pretty much the new Two Girls, One Cup.
It's not
This is old. This is an old ass thing.
And I'm just now told about this.
I actually don't know what y'all are talking about, so.
Don't.
But I'm not gonna look it up.
Yeah, good.
Yes, I am innocent. I prefer to keep it that way. Thank you.
Come on. Darth! Fuck!
Saying don't look up something, it's like saying look it up right there.
Oh, that's the
son of a bitch!
That's all. When's everybody's birthday?
So fucking slow when it comes to those cannonballs.
Are you a friend? My birthday's on my Twitter, I guess.
September 28th, 1997.
That's how old it is?
Kitties.
June 4th,
1986. Wait, are we all asking our birth dates?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh. June 22nd, 1988.